Hello everyone, you're listening to OTV Top 10 with Deepti Ranjan. Today is the 1st of December and here are the top news of the day.
The Bhubaneswar Centre of the India Meteorological Department informed that the low pressure system formed over the central Andaman Sea has been active and will intensify into depression by tomorrow while moving in west-southwest direction. As per reports, the system is likely to make landfall on North Andhra South Odisha coasts in the early hours of December 4. Under its influence, rainfall activities will commence from the evening of December 3, informed the Met Office. According to the Meteorological Department, heavy rainfall is very likely to occur at isolated places over the districts of Gajapati, Ganjam, Puri and Jagatsinghpur on December 3rd. Let's hear what the IMD DG Chief Mrutyunjay Mahapatra had to say on the matter.
Asanta kali gotiye depression re parinat hebo dakshina purba bangop sagar ebong yar nikatastha purba kendra bangop sagar re ebong 3 tarikh re eha gotiye cyclone storm ba batya re parinat hei pare kendra bangop sagar re 4 tarikh re north andhra pradesh ebong odisha upakul nikatastha samudra re asi यह पहुँच चार तारीख सका से गोटे सीभीयर साइक्लोन स्टॉर्म हिसाब से आँची पारे यार प्रभाव में ओडिशार जो उपकूलवर्ती जिले में होती सेठे तीन तारीख संध्या किंवा रातिर वर्षा आरंभ हो पारे सामान्य मध्यम धरणर अल्प केतक स्थान में विशेषतः दक्षिण ओडिशार उपकूलवर्ती जिला मानक हेवी रेनफॉल तीन तारीख में हो पारे 4 तारीख में वर्षार परिमाण बढ़ समग्र ओडिशा वर्षा होगा सहित उपकूलवर्ती जिला मानक निकटस्थ अभ्यंतरण जिला मानक हेवी टू भेरी हेवी रेनफॉल किसी जगह हो पारे और अल्प किसी जगह विशेषतः उपकूलवर्ती जिला मानक एक्सट्रीमली हेवी रेनफॉल माने अत्यंत प्रबल वर्षा जाए 20 सेंटीमीटर अधिक ता 4 तारीख रे हो पारे।
द दिल्ली गवर्नमेंट रिड्यूस्ड वैट ऑन पेट्रोल टू 19.40% फ्रॉम 30% टुडे। विद दिस द प्राइस ऑफ पेट्रोल इन दिल्ली रिड्यूस्ड बाय ₹8 पर लीटर। एज पर रिपोर्ट्स द न्यू रेट्स विल कम इनटू इफेक्ट फ्रॉम मिडनाइट टुडे। इन अनदर मेजर डेवलपमेंट द नेशनल ऑयल मार्केटिंग कंपनीज हैव इंक्रीज्ड द प्राइस ऑफ कमर्शियल 19 केजी एलपीजी सिलेंडर बाय ₹100.50 टेकिंग द न्यू प्राइस टू ₹2,101 in Delhi. This increase in price of LPG cylinders is effective from today.
December 1 is World AIDS Day and throughout the day, there has been a buzz all around the world on HIV or AIDS statistics and estimates. This year's World AIDS Day theme is End Inequalities, End AIDS, End Pandemics. Post-COVID, we seem to have forgotten the 2.1 million people living with HIV in India. This World AIDS Day, UNAIDS has highlighted the urgent need to end inequalities that drive AIDS and other pandemics around the world.
The World Health Organization or WHO has warned that blanket travel bans will not prevent the international spread of COVID-19 Omicron variant even after dozens of countries have already introduced such restrictions. Although Omicron has been labeled a variant of concern by WHO, it is said that the blanket travel ban will only place a heavy burden on the lives and livelihoods. WHO informed that it is also disincentivizing countries to report and share epidemiological and sequencing data.
Bollywood Live Wire star Ranveer Singh shared an emotional note after the trailer of his upcoming film 83 received immense love and appreciation from fans. The actor finds it an honor to be a part of the cinematic telling of the iconic story of the players who brought the World Cup home in 1983. Ranveer plays the role of the legendary Indian cricket team captain Kapil Dev, who led the underdog unit to the coveted World Cup glory in 1983 as they beat the mighty West Indies team in the finals at Lord's Cricket Ground. In a heartfelt note posted on his social media, Ranveer thanked the movie fans and said that the people from all walks of life and generations have appreciated the movie's trailer. Ranveer also said that 83 is not just a movie, it's a glorious tribute to that moment in Indian history that changed it all.
Virat Kohli, Rohit Sharma and MS Dhoni were retained by their respective franchises, Royal Challengers Bangalore, Mumbai Indians and Chennai Super Kings, as BCCI unveiled their retention list ahead of IPL mega auction. KL Rahul, Rashid Khan and Hardik Pandya are among the big names that haven't been retained by their franchises. The three players along with other release players will now be in the pool from which two new IPL teams, Ahmedabad and Lucknow, will be reformed.
The Supreme Court agreed to hear pleas challenging two ordinances extending tenure of ED and CBI chiefs before December 17. A lawyer mentioned the plea challenging the ordinances before a bench headed by Chief Justice N.B. Raman for early hearing. The bench said it will hear the matter and plans to tag together all similar petitions and then fix it for hearing. The advocate requested to hear it before the beginning of winter vacation of the top court, which begins from December 17, as the centre has already extended the tenure of ED chief and therefore there is some urgency.
Goods and services tax collections jumped to over 1.31 lakh crore in November, the second highest since its implementation in July 2017. Finance Ministry in a statement said that the gross GST revenue collected in the month of November 2021 is 1,31,526 crore, of which the central goods and service taxes is 23,978 crore, state goods and service tax is ₹31,127 crore, IGST is ₹66,815 crore, and cess is ₹9,606 crore, including ₹653 crore collected from import of goods.
Twitter has announced to ban sharing of private media such as photos and videos without permission from the individuals that are shown in those images. The microblogging platform already covers explicit instances of abusive behavior under its policies. The expansion of the policy will allow the platform to take action on media that is shared without any explicit abusive content, provided it's posted without the consent of the person depicted. Twitter in a blog post said that sharing personal media such as images or videos can potentially violate a person's privacy and may lead to emotional or physical harm.
Odisha Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik inaugurated 7 industrial projects and laid foundation stones to 10 projects involving a total investment of rupees 1000 crore. According to officials, the 7 inaugurated units have been set up with an investment of 152 crore, while the proposed investment plan for 10 industrial units is worth 848 crore. The projects range from food processing, tourism, plastic, manufacturing to fertilizer sectors and will create potential employment for over 24,000 persons in the state.
So that's it for today. For news in detail, visit odishatv.in, Odisha's premier destination for news updates in English. This is Akanksha signing off.